Recording our own thriving story. My name is Jahkim Hendrix Hendrix. I am from East Palo Alto, California. So a little bit about the theme of my letter. The S signifies my grandmother, great-grandmother, and my mother. The reason why I chose this design was because I wanted something that was powerful and that made a statement, but that was also relevant to this project. And so the fact that I chose a fist, I feel like it represents, again, resilience. Because when you think of resilience, you think of strength, you think of power. And so when I think of that hand motion or that hand gesture represents power. And so that was the first thing that was in my creative thought process. That would be the first thing I thought of. And so the largest hand actually represents my great-grandmother and her struggle with at a time where racism appeared and she was in the South. And so knowing her story, I think that kind of represents her moving from the South and more specifically Oklahoma to a place like California and having to go from San Francisco to East Palo Alto in that transition. I think that represents power in itself. And then I think the next hand represents my grandmother. She also was born in a time of racism and oppression, trying to get a really good education in her fight of trying to find opportunities and jobs that were equal. And I think that's really relevant. And then the last hand, which would be the smallest hand, represents my mother. Because even though she is in her generation compared to my grandmother, my grandmother, my great-grandmother, she still had to fight too, because her strength of being a mother has shown me that time and time again, how much she loves her kids and how much she'll do anything for us. And so that's why she has that powerful symbol as well. So if you look at the three fists, you see there are lines, and that is basically a map. Kind of shows the struggle that East Palo Alto also went through in being incorporated, and have so many times, such as like the educational system, that people actually, you know, needed a school or housing. They were provided, but they were also taken away from people. And so I wanted to show that because we stood the test of time and we still continue to do that